Welcome. Now let us discuss about the pressure belts of the world. Before going into that, what is air pressure? Air pressure is the pressure that is exerted by the air on the surface of the earth. Let us now look at the varying pressure on the earth. Let us first look at the equator. Now this equator, the zone of the equator from approximately 5 degree north to 5 degree south, this belt, now why do we call it belt? It looks like a belt around the earth. So this belt, this receives direct sunlight throughout the year. So we find more temperature in this belt. The air molecules that are present here, these receive that more temperature. They get more energy and now they have the energy to overcome the gravitational force of the earth. So they begin to rise up due to that energy. Now here, due to more temperature, the air molecules rise up, and here there are less molecules now. So this results in low pressure. We call this the low pressure belt, as low pressure is present. Now let us look at the relationship between temperature and pressure. Here the temperature is high in the equatorial zone. So the pressure, as we have seen, is low. In the same way, in other places, if the temperature is low, then we find that the pressure is high. So mathematically, if we write the expression, we can write it as temperature is inversely proportional to pressure. So now let us look at the polar zones. The poles, near the poles, we find the lowest temperatures. That is, the temperature is very low. So what is the result of the pressure? It is very high. So here we find high pressure belt in the northern pole as well as the southern hemisphere, south pole. So as a result, now it is high pressure, which means this region has higher pressure than the remaining surrounding regions. So these regions have lower pressure than this one. So these are low pressure zones. This one too, in the southern hemisphere. So we know that air has a tendency to move from high pressure to low pressure. As this is high pressure, this is low pressure, the air moves in this direction. So from here, in this way. Now what happens, let's take a step back, come to the equator again. What happens to the rise, the air that is rising now? So here, as it rises up to some extent, which is known as tropopause, that limit, this air begins to cool down. It dissipates its energy in the form of heat, and it begins to become cool and dense and become sluggish. So it begins to fall down again. In this way, few to the north and some to the south. Now here it begins to fall down due to the gravitational pull of the earth, the north as well as in the south. Now in these zones, this one and this one, we find that already there are molecules, and more air molecules have come and reached this place. So this results in a high pressure. So this belt we call it high pressure belt. The same here too, high pressure belt. Now what happens to the air that has reached here? See, this is high pressure and this is low pressure. So these move from high pressure to low pressure now. In this way. High pressure to low pressure. Now as you can see here, this completes a cycle. As we can see, this is a cycle. In the same way. And one more thing. Here, from the high pressure, not only this is a low pressure, this is also a low pressure belt. So this air not only moves this side, also this side. In this way, the same thing here. Now what happens here? The air, the wind is coming from high pressure belt to low pressure belt, this side too. So these both converge together and the air here rises up, ascending air. Just same as the case of the equator, as the air rises, here low pressure belt is formed. So in a similar way, this belt is low pressure, as we have discussed before. Now in a similar way, this air also falls down after a particular limit. towards the poles like this, as well as here. Now these, here we find the same happens in the southern hemisphere also. In this way, this is one, and here we find another. In this way. Now here you find few cycles in this way. These cycles ensure that the heat is equally distributed across the Earth's atmosphere. We find three main cells here, these cycles. These are known as cells. This first one is known as Hadley cell. Then this is known as Ferrel cell.
What is the range Hadley cell from?
Yeah. Here, Hadley cell from 0 degrees equator to 30 degrees north and south.
Right down.
Yeah, okay. So, Hadley cell 0 degrees to 30 degrees. Ferrel cell is from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. While this one, as it is situated in the polar region, polar cell from 60 degrees to 90 degrees. In a similar way, this is also a Hadley cell from 0 degrees to 30 degrees south. This is a Ferrel cell from 30 degrees to 60 degrees south. And this is polar cell from 60 degrees to 90 degrees south. Now these are the cells. Now let us look at the belts again. We find a pattern here, right? This is high pressure, low pressure, high, low, high, low, high. In this way. Now let us name these belts for our convenience. This belt is situated on the equator, so we call this equatorial low pressure belt. Okay, here the wind is sluggish, it is slow, so we also call this region as doldrums. Also, this region is known as ITCZ, that is intertropical convergence zone. This is because the trade winds that are present here on this side and this side, these both converge in this zone. So, intertropical convergence zone. Then, this particular zone, this is present outside the tropics, to the above and to the below of the tropics. You see, this is 23.5 degree north, which is Tropic of Cancer, and this is 23.5 degree south, which is the Tropic of Capricorn. These are 30 degrees, approximately 30 degrees and 30 degrees. So, these are present outside the tropics. So, we can call it subtropical. So, these are subtropical high pressure belt. This is subtropical high pressure belt to the south. Also, these regions, these latitudes are known as horse latitudes. Mainly because legend has it that the European traders, their ships used to decom here due to the slow winds, and due for the conservation of the water, they used to throw the horses overboard from the ship in these near these latitudes. So horse these latitudes are known as horse latitudes near 30 degrees. Next we come here. In a similar way, this is the polar region, polar zone, as this is 66.5 degrees north Arctic Circle. As it is present outside, to the south of the polar zone, we call this as subpolar. Subpolar low. This one is also subpolar low. Then, you might have guessed it by now, this is polar, as it is situated in the polar zone. This one is also polar high. This is also polar high pressure belt. Now, these are the pressure belts. Now, let us discuss about the winds. First, the planetary winds. What are these planetary winds? The winds that blow in the same direction throughout the year are known as planetary winds. Alright, these planetary winds. Now, these blow from high pressure belts to the low pressure belts. Now, according to that, from high pressure belt to the low pressure belt in this way, in the similar way, from high pressure belt to the low pressure belt. But this is not the case in the real Earth, because these wind direction is affected by another factor known as Coriolis effect. What is Coriolis effect? This Coriolis effect is the effect due to, it is the effect on winds due to the rotation of the earth on its own axis. As the earth rotates, because of it, the winds change their direction. They deflect. Now let us see how they deflect. Let us suppose this is the earth, this is the 0 degrees equator, you are standing here. We are facing north, like this. So, there is a wind. This is the expected path of the wind. Just like this, from high pressure to low pressure, this is the wind. Now, in the northern hemisphere, the winds deflect to their right due to the Coriolis effect. So, what is its right? We are looking at the North Pole. This is its right. Similarly, in the southern hemisphere, let us suppose this is the expected path of the wind. Then, we are now looking towards the south in this way. Now, what is its... In the southern hemisphere, the winds deflect towards their left. So, what is its left now? This side. So, they deflect towards the left in this way. Now, this is how the winds get deflected due to the Coriolis effect in the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. Let us apply the same concept here now. Before that, these are the expected paths here from high pressure to low pressure. This one from high pressure to low pressure, like this. Here too, high pressure to low pressure in this way. These are the expected paths. Now, let's see how the real paths are. Let us now look at the northern hemisphere. This is the wind, this is the expected path. What is its right? This side. So, it deflects towards its right in this way. So, this is the actual path of the of these winds in this way. Similarly, this one, this is in the northern hemisphere, this is its expected path, it deflects towards its right. So, this is its right. You stand here, you are looking at the direction of the wind, then towards its right, it deflects. So, this is the actual path of these winds. Then, in here, this is the expected path, this is its right in this way. So, it deflects towards its right in this way. This is the actual path. Now, let's come to the southern hemisphere. Here, the winds deflect towards their left. Here, this is the expected path. You are here, you are looking at it. This is its left. So, it deflects towards left in this way. So this is the actual path. Then, here, this is its expected path. It is in this way. This is its left. So, this is its actual path in this way. Here also, similarly, this is its left. So, these are the actual path of these winds. Now, let's name these winds. Here, these winds, these helped in the sailing of the European trade ships. So, these are known as trade winds, as they helped for the trade. Also, these are known with their direction of the origin. These originate in the northeast, so these are known as northeast trade winds. While these originate in the southeast, so these are known as southeast trade winds. They blow from the subtropical high pressure belt to the equatorial low pressure belt. Then, here we find these winds. Another thing to mention is that the Coriolis effect increases as we go from the equator to the poles. So, in these regions, the Coriolis effect is more than these regions. So, these winds, even though they originate from here, they appear to be originating from the west. They appear in that way. So, these are known as Westerlies, as they appear to originate from the west. Similar way here, Westerlies. As these also seem to originate from the west. You might have guessed it. Here also, due to the more Coriolis effect, these seem to originate from the east. Now, from here. So, these are known as Easterlies. Here also, from the east they seem to originate. So, these are known as Easterlies. Now, these are characterized like these are, this is north Easterlies and south. One thing to mention here is that the southwesterlies are stronger than the northwesterlies, because here we find the ocean which is even, and but near the northwesterlies uneven land relief forms can be found, so these are stronger from 40 degrees, 50 degrees, and 60 degrees. These here we find the southwesterlies. So traders, the navigators, they called them. This is for the 40 degrees. These are known as roaring 40s. 50 degrees south are known as furious 50s. While 60 degrees south latitudes are known as shrieking 60s. So they are so powerful in this way. Now this is not it. These are just planetary winds. One type of winds. We will discuss about the seasonal winds, local winds, about that in my coming class.